Good morning and welcome back to the next class of Theory of Computation. In this class, we are going to learn about non-deterministic finite automata. Non-deterministic finite automata is similar to that of deterministic finite automata except for the fact that delta is given by q into sigma derives to 2 to the power q, that is the power set of q. Let us design a non-deterministic finite automata NFA to accept the strings over A and B which are ending with B. So the language that will be accepted by this finite automata will be L equals to B, BB, AB, ABB, AAB, BAB, BBB, BAA, BB and so on, such that the all strings must be ending with a B. So to make this NFA, let us start with an initial state as Q1. From Q1, to accept the first string B, we must go to a final state by reading B from Q1. So there must be a transition from Q1 to a final state Q2 on reading B. So this automata now will accept the string B. To accept the next string BB, the automata may start from Q1, read a B and go to Q1. Or on getting the first B, the automata may go to Q1, from Q1 to Q2, and on Q2 it may read a B and be in Q2. Let us consider the first case. From Q1, the automata reads the first B and go to Q1, and on reading the next B, it goes to Q2. So the BB will be accepted by this NFA. From Q1, it may again accept the string BB and be in Q1, and after reading third B, it transit to Q2. So the string with n number of Bs will be accepted over here. Consider the third string AB. To accept this AB, automata must read A in Q1 and B in Q1, so that when the next B is read, it must go to final state. So in this case, consider the string AAB. So to accept AAB, the automata must read the A and B in Q1 only, and as soon as the last B is read, it must go to Q2. So there must be a transition from Q1 on A to Q1 itself. So this will accept any number of A's followed by a B will be accepted, right? Or any combination of A and B that ends with a B will be accepted by this NFA. On Q2, you may read A or B as input, but that must not be accepted. So it should go to a dead state like this. On Q2, if I get A or B, it is going to a dead state and then I will continue in the dead state. In case of DFA, we have to show transitions for all the input on all the state. In case of NFA, it is not necessary to show transition on all inputs from all the states. Some transitions can be omitted from the NFA. So we can omit this transition. This is optional in case of NFA. So this is a correct NFA that will accept all the string that will end with a B. Now this is called as NFA because there is multiple transition from state Q1 on the input B. So if any transition or any state or symbol input combination produces multiple output state, then it is a NFA. Like here, when the Q1 state is there and A is the input, transition is to Q1. This is fixed. But in Q1, if B is the input, the transition can be either to Q1 or to Q2. So in Q1, if I get B as input, the automata can stay in Q1 or it may transit the state to Q2. Right? So this produces the non-determinism in this NFA or in this finite automata. This makes it as non-deterministic. Whereas in Q2, if I get A, there is no transition, so I go to phi. And in Q2, if I get a B, there is again no transition, so again I go to a phi. So the possible output states in this NFA are 2 to the power Q. That is, it can go to phi, or it can go to a single state Q1, or it can go to a single state Q2, or it may go to multiple state as Q1 and Q2. So 2 to the power q is nothing but a set of all the subsets of q. So these are the possible subset, and through this automata you can go among any of this particular sets, right? So consider a string babb and give this as input to this automata and check whether it will be accepted or not. So we'll start from the initial state. On getting first b, the automata reads the first B. So here there are two possibilities, there are two transitions that can occur. That is, in Q1, if I get a B, I can go to Q1 or I can go to Q2. So there are two possibilities. So on getting B in Q1, the output can be new state Q1 or a new state Q2. In Q1, the next input must be read, that is A. In Q1, I get A. So the transition on Q1 on A is to Q1 only. This is fixed. But in Q2, if I get a A, so there is no transition. This condition is called as a dead configuration. So this automata or this transition will stop over here and will not move ahead. Will stop over here in this direction. In this Q1, the next input will be B. So in Q1, if I get a B, there are two possibilities again. The transition can be to Q1 or the transition can be to Q2. If the transition is in Q1, so in Q1, again the next input will be B. And in Q1, if I get a B, again there are two possibilities. Either go to Q1, and if it goes to Q1, it will reject, or go to Q2 to accept the string. So this will reject the string as the string is read completely, but there is no final state at the end. So this will reject the string. But in this Q1, if I read B and go to Q2, so this will be the accept state. And I started from the initial state, read the complete string and reached a final state. So this will accept the string. Whereas if I consider this Q2, there is an input B from this in this state, but there is no transition on B from this state, so this will again go to a dead configuration. That is, there is no movement possible. So this three case will reject the string, whereas this case will accept the string. So for any string to be accepted by the non-deterministic finite automata, we need to consider all the possibilities, all the possible transitions, so as to make the decision. If all the transitions rejects the string, then the string will be rejected by the NFA. If any of the transition reaches the final state, then the string will be accepted by the non-deterministic finite automata. So the string BABB is accepted by the finite automata as there is one possible transition that ends in a final state. NFA can be represented by a transition table as follows, where Q1 is the initial state, Q1 on A goes to a single state Q1, whereas Q1 on B, there are two possibilities, that is Q1 or Q2, which is represented by a set. And this set is nothing but a part of the power set of Q. In Q2, which is the final state, there is a dead configuration. On reading A, there is no transition. On reading B, there is no transition. That is phi. It's an empty transition. We'll stop over here. And in the next class, we'll see the difference between non-deterministic finite automata and deterministic finite automata. Thank you.